Victor Oladipo came up to me after the dunk contest. He was like, bro, you didn't even know what you just did. And I was like, yeah, I was just in it.
All right, Aaron, appreciate you coming on the show.
Hey, no problem.
You're doing the 2020 NBA Slam Dunk Contest. So I thought it would be right if we went through all of your best dunks from 2016. So the first dunk, and I feel like this is a very underrated dunk that people have kind of slept on. What was your thought on it?
Yeah, I mean, it was slept on. Like, I don't think anybody really knew what to expect from me at this point. But, like, that's a 360 through the legs.
Yeah.
It's a 10. You know what I mean? So it was kind of just like a wake-up call. Just let everybody know that I'm here. Mm-hmm. You know, I was like, okay, I'm here. I do this. I'm here to win. You know, like that. You know what I mean? That's what that gesture was. And, it's just something that I knew I could put in, because you definitely want to make your first dunk.
How nervous were you before the dunk contest? Like, at this moment, right before your first dunk, are you feeling the energy? Are you feeling the nerves?
Oh, yeah. Oh, big nervous. Yeah. Big nervous. But, you know, it's a lot of, like mental reps, you know, seeing yourself go through it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, a lot of visualization, a lot of practice, mental training.
Yeah.
And, you know, I just harnessed all the energy. Like, it was crazy energy in the crowd. You know, you see all the celebrities on the road, you know what I mean? All the people that you've been looking up to, all the players. And, I used the energy to jump higher.
Yeah. What's your strategy, though? Because you never want to lead with your first dunk. Like, your best dunk, you don't want it to be your first dunk, right?
Yeah. No, I mean,
so, like, do you save it for the third round, fourth round? Like, what? When do you save it? Like, when do you have your best dunk?
Oh, the last one.
The last one.
Yeah, for sure. You want to always end with a bang.
Yeah. Now, this one was like a very competitive one. You had like Drummond, you had Zach LaVine. When someone breaks out like a crazy dunk, you're like, oh, it's a 50. Does that put pressure on you? Like, yo, I have to match that right away. Like, does that change your strategy at all?
It's more like a, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, okay, yeah. Okay. We got some competition. Okay. You know what I mean? It's kind of like that, you know, like, we're all competitors at the end of the day, so that's really what it comes down to. It's like that feeling, like,
yeah,
you know, okay, okay. Well,
they kept doing that during your dunks, because let's watch this one. I feel like the reaction to this one was all the players doing, okay, okay, how did he do this? How did he do this? What made you decide to use the mascot?
It just seemed fitting.
Yeah.
You know, it seemed fitting. I needed an assist.
Mm-hmm.
The mascot actually has a background in gymnastics.
Okay.
So, you know, he was able to stay on top of the little sideboard of the hoverboard while I jumped over him. And, he was just a good sport, man. He's a good friend of mine. And, threw the legs over somebody.
Are you planning on using him again for this year's dunk contest?
I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure. I think that I might pull somebody from the crowd.
Okay.
Stuff is a great part of the show. So I'm not sure. I might.
Yeah. Now, standing on the hoverboard, how tall is he?
Man.
Because he's tall.
Yeah, he was about 6'5", maybe 6'4", on the hoverboard. So, yeah, he's big.
So that makes it even more impressive.
Yeah, you had to get up over him for sure.
Now, how do you come up with this? Like, are your teammates pitching you? Are you coming on? Like, are you thinking of it on your own? Like, what's going on?
The scoop, the 360 scoop.
You know, all of it. I just want to know how all the idea, like most of the dunks, who's coming up with them? Is it mainly you? Is it your teammates? Is it coaches?
Man,
friends?
It's a compilation and a collaboration of just living.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, just everything that happens in life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Through seeing other people dunk, like the N1 dudes dunking, you know, seeing the NBA legends before me coming and dunk. You see, like, the video games, like NBA Live dunk contest, NBA Street dunk contest. You see dudes at the park that I used to play with doing crazy dunks back in the day, you know, dunking on the mini hoops, dunking on the Nerf hoops. So it's just like an accumulation of life coming together and manifesting itself in front of, you know, thousands and thousands of people.
Now, how long are you practicing them before this weekend of the All-Star break? Like, at what point do you start practicing these dunks?
Yeah, so I'll probably start practicing when I get back to Orlando.
Yeah.
Now I really wanted to put on a show for this one, so I practiced for about 1 to 2 weeks. This time I get a little bit less time to practice. I think the dunks are a little less technical than the 2016, but still gonna be spectacular.
Yeah. Now on this third dunk, I want to give you credit for your presentation because you stopped and you said, I want you to start spinning.
Yeah.
The presentation was very underrated for this dunk contest. And this is one of my favorite ones because the scoop is very underrated. It's very hard to just grab it like that, right?
Yeah, that was tough, man. I really surprised myself on that. You could tell by my reaction.
Yeah.
Like I was surprised, you know, because in practice I was throwing the ball all over the gym, man.
Yeah.
And so that initially I was going to put my hand behind my head. Mm-hmm. I thought it was going to be too difficult to do. And then I just decided to do it midair. I was like, okay, I got some time up here.
Do you ever impress yourself? Like this is the one where you, this is the dunk where you impress yourself,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, so that was the one where it was just like, oh man, I got this, man. I'm really doing this right now.
Now, when you look and watch the video and you see all the player reactions, even a kid reacts in the crowd, does that kind of get you excited? Like, yo, I got so many people, all eyes were on me, and all of these players lost it when I was dunking.
Yeah, I mean, it was great, man. It just to see the level of excitement. I mean,
look at Mutombo. It was a meme. It was a meme, right. Remember? Everyone was doing all of these types of jokes because of stuff that you were doing. But the next dunk is my favorite dunk that I've ever seen in a dunk contest. Listen, Vince Carter is great, and I would put this dunk right up there with Vince Carter stuff because just walk me through it.
Oh, man. So I had never even attempted that dunk before. Like, I started practicing for the dunk contest.
Yeah.
It's like, it's real technical, man. It's you don't want to fall on your butt, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're up there so high, you know? That was for a younger me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was definitely for a younger me. I was a little bit more reckless. You got to approach with like good speed,
mm-hmm.
and really stick. You got to get the ball real secure in your hands, right there. You got to secure the ball really well,
mm-hmm.
and then you actually have to use the rim to counterbalance yourself. Or if you don't grab the rim, like you're gonna like be way off balance and you might fall over. So
yeah.
You actually need to finish the dunk, or it could go bad.
Well, thank God you did.
That's what I'm saying, man. For real. So this is a good one.
Now there were 6 dunks that you did during this dunk contest. Was this your favorite one?
Yeah, it was between that one and the spinning scoop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at the crowd, you look at the audience, everyone is saying it's over after the fourth dunk.
Mm.
Even Kenny Smith yelled, it's over, it's over. Did you think it was over?
Oh, yeah, for sure. For sure. I was like, look, I went like this. Like, it's wrapped up. Time to roll out. Everybody, time to go home.
Yeah.
I think they misinterpreted that for, like, let's keep the show rolling.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that was not it. So, you know, they got me. It got me, man. I signed up for 4 dunks, came, I conquered. They got me for 2 more dunks. So.
Now,
it is what it is.
I am curious, after this dunk contest, you were talking about celebrities. Did celebrities reach out to you after the fact? Like, and was there ever a point where you were starstruck?
Yeah, man. Yeah. Jessica Alba.
What?
Yeah, she was like, man, Gordon killed that. And I was like, man, that's
crazy. Yeah. I hear you. There's a stat here. It says, so Aaron Gordon's dunk would have finished 3rd in the high jump in the last Olympics. Did you know that fact?
Yeah, but it's a little skewed. You know
what
I mean?
Tell me why.
I mean, if I could bring stuff to the high jumps and jump over him, you know, maybe I'd be a little bit better. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, I mean, it's dope. You know what I mean? It's a dope stat. You know, I really feel like I'm one of the best athletes in the world.
Yeah.
So it's really cool to just be compared against other great athletes like that.
Yeah. What's your vertical, by the way? Can you say?
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
It's got to be up there in the league, though, for sure.
Some days it's like 12 inches, and some days it's like 50 inches, you know? So, like,
I'm
not sure.
And now, dunk number 5. You weren't expecting to dunk number 5.
Mm.
So, did you still have some dunks planned, or was it at this point all off the top?
This was off the top. This was all improv.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just so grateful that EP showed up.
Yeah.
And he was there in the crowd because, you know, after practice, we had just like been messing around with alley-oops and stuff like this. And this was some of the things that we did after practice. So, like, I'm so grateful that he was there. Threw a perfect pass in the streetwear.
Yeah.
Just solid, you know what I mean? Just solid.
It's a great one. Was this an a Shaq? When you see Shaq's reaction, because he doesn't do this, like Shaq never reacts like that. You get the 50. Is it cool to see, like, think about it. Everyone grew up watching Shaq, and he starts reacting like that to stuff that you're doing. That must be cool.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. So it's a beautiful thing just to have like that panel of judges was so dope too, you know what I mean?
I think even
like,
Kevin Hart was commentating over there too, and he was like losing his mind.
He was, yeah. He was trying to run out and get me dabs, like mid dunk contest. Yeah. Like they were like, I had to calm him down.
Was this your I made it moment? Like this dunk contest in general of like, this puts you on the map on another level. Not that people didn't know who Aaron Gordon was before, but now they definitely know who Aaron Gordon is.
Yeah, I think it kind of just showed people the athleticism.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That unique athleticism. And it was cool, man. You know, yeah. I love doing stuff like this. You know what I mean? I love interacting with the crowd. I love interacting with people. I love just the bright lights, the entertainment of it. So it's just like, it's right up my alley. It's my speed all day, every day. So,
sure.
It's out.
Now the last dunk, I want to know something. You were trying something off the shot clock at first. What were you planning? What were you trying to do here?
I was out. I was out of ideas, man. I was out of ideas.
That would have been crazy. That's why I had to ask.
Off the shot clock, but right. So that's a little creative. So that's like one of those video game dunks. You know what I mean?
And then, so what made you change your mind? You were just like, it seems too difficult, or it's not as great as you think it might be. Like, what made you change your mind in the moment?
I think I just wanted to go with the dunk that I've made before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, this dunk, I do want to say, I felt like was your most underrated dunk. Like, when you watch the replays, it's amazing. And I think it should be a 50, seriously.
Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely a 50 dunk. But like, I think
so
people don't understand it if you don't watch basketball.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You know how much basketball you watch?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So you appreciate it. You understand it. You understand like the level of difficulty that that takes. But like to just like the regular person,
it might be difficult for them.
Yeah, they don't they don't really just grasp it. It's just like, what did he even just do?
Yeah. You know what I mean? So at this point though, you're still expecting to win it, right?
Nah, I knew I lost.
Yeah. A lot of people though on Twitter were saying that they felt you were robbed. Did you feel that way?
Yeah, for sure, for sure. And like, I didn't even know what I had done. Like that's what Victor Oladipo came up to me after the dunk contest. He was like, bro, you didn't even know what you just did. And I was like, yeah, I was just in it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But like now that I watch it, it was wrapped up after four.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it was wrapped up after four.
So what made you do it this year? Is it like, hey, I didn't win in 2016 and I want to get that revenge? Or is it something else?
Hey, I think we should have played the highlights or the lowlights of the 2017 dunk.
No, concert. I didn't want to do that.
We should have done that. We should have brought that back. That's really the fire. You know what I mean? That's the spark. That's like, it goes unsung. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
My heart wasn't in it.
Mm-hmm.
The drone, it really wasn't even my idea.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I thought it was a great idea.
Yeah.
But you know, it just wasn't right.
Yeah.
Wasn't true to myself. I got out there.
Yeah.
I had the ball. I was looking around the crowd, saw everybody. I was like, damn, what the hell am I doing here? Like, you know what I mean? Yeah, I don't even want to be here right now. It was over after that. It was toast.
Yeah.
So I just, for my own soul,
yeah,
I got to do it again. I love dunking. Love dunk contests. Got love the lights. Need the redemption.
The competition's good too. You have like Dwight Howard, who's won a couple times, or he's won once. And then Derrick Jones Jr. Are you excited about the competition?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, everybody can fly, and people are sleeping on Pat too. Like Pat could fly too.
Mm-hmm.
Dwight already has one. I know he's gonna have the whole crowd.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He's gonna have everybody invested. D. Jones, he flies like a bird, and so that level of competition is gonna be great.
Well, I appreciate you coming on the show. Next time we do this, because we're gonna do this again, we're gonna do your 2020 dunk contest, and then we're gonna do all your amazing dunks during games, even like your 40-point game. So we gotta do this again, all right?
All right, for sure.
Later, bro. Appreciate it.
Yeah, no doubt.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports analysis and highlights, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.